I wanted that to be, if I'm buying here, it's, what is the price? 26, 20 pips higher, 246. That would be 20 pips. Now, here's the great thing about this window is it calculates it all there for you. Okay? It's all down here. And I can see 1 pip equals 4 pounds. My trade value is 100,000 pounds. The margin used is $3,000 roughly. Here's my take profit is for, pardon me, 92 pounds is what that's going to equal. My stop loss is at 36 pounds. Okay? So everything is set in place, and then I can go ahead and click on the submit button. Let me bring this up just a little bit, cut off the top. I can click on the submit button. Now, here's something. If you're placing multiple orders, you want to check this box to keep the window open. This is effective if you're placing multiple orders on a fast-moving report. You can keep clicking submit to add to your position or take away from your position. It just makes it handier than fumbling around with the order windows, and you can just keep it on your screen while you're watching your chart. Okay, so that's what the default bounds box is going to be. Now, you can see that you can set it as a percentage of price. I would rather use this as pips. So the default bounds, I'm going to go ahead and set at 20. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and lower that down 15. Okay, the default stop loss, you can set this in pips. There's 15 pips. I'll go ahead and set that to 30. Default take profit, I'm going to go ahead and set that to 20. And the default limit order duration. This is something that you've got to be very careful with, especially with live trading. Always, always, always know where your orders are. Okay, what you have pending, what you don't have pending, what's going to be coming up for cancellation. So if you have an order waiting out there and you want it to be out there, you're going to have to need to know when those are going to be canceled. My preference is a day. I don't like things hanging out there for any length of time, really. Now, in the stock market, if you're familiar with this, these are called, you have what are called GTC, good till canceled order, or good for the day. This is the normal order. This, you've got to tell your broker, I want to buy IBM at $115 GTC, okay? I set this to a day. But you can see here that you can set these, look at this, you can set it all the way down to an hour, where Owanda will automatically cancel out your order at the end of an hour. Now, this is very important down here. If you're trying to enter in orders quickly, you're going to want to enable bounds by default, enable stop loss and take profit by default. You can see this show confirmation windows. If you're going to be buying, it's going to come up and say, are you sure? I like to take those off, okay? And I like to confirm a position reversal because that way if I'm getting a little spastic, if something's going on, I'm just getting really caught up and I'm reversing a position, the software will stop me and say, hey, do you really want to reverse that? Now, I don't want to do that for a normal order, but I do want that in place for a position reversal because that'll stop me from getting whipsawed around. Now, I'll go ahead over here to the miscellaneous. This, the show action buttons, this is applying to the side here.